As a River Forecast Center forecaster, we develop a working knowledge about the rivers and streams in our forecast area. In a flood situation, this knowledge can be critical for interagency collaborations and accounting for important factors such as reservoir operations, local stream behaviors, infrastructure effects, the impact of forecast calibrations, and the impact of precipitation forces. It can therefore be beneficial to replace National Water Model flow forecasts with River Forecast Center flow forecasts where available, and then route these River Forecast Center flows downstream for the derivation of inundation extent.
This is the basis for the River Forecast Center RFC Flood Inundation Mapping FIM. We start with the National Water Model NWM Stream Reach Network and insert the RFC forecast flow at the RFC forecast points. The RFC flow forecasts are then routed downstream from the forecast points. Note that parts of the NWM reach network have no flow forecasts by the RFC. The routed flow is converted to stage height using synthetic rating curves, and the height above nearest drainage method, or HAND, is applied to generate the aerial extent of flooding. This process is similar to that used for the NWM FIM. There is no direct depth information. The main advantage of the RFC FIM over the NWM FIM is that the RFC FIM is based on the official RFC flow forecasts. This consistency can be very useful in a flood situation, especially when complex processes are in play. While RFC FIM incorporates newly issued RFC forecasts every hour, it's important to keep in mind that the RFC forecasts, which are the basis of the RFC FIM, may not update as regularly. The NWM FIM updates on an automatic cycle, either hourly or every 6 hours. Since RFC FIM is directly tied to RFC point forecasts, the updates to RFC FIM are dependent upon the issuance time of a given forecast, and it can take 1 to 2 hours for the latest forecast to be reflected in the RFC FIM service. The RFC FIM is available for any official river forecast point which is at or forecast to be at or above action stage. Potential inconsistency between RFC FIM and other NWM visualizations exists. For example, the NWM flow forecast may trigger inundation in one area, but the RFC flow forecast may trigger inundation in a different area. Let's consider a scenario where a WFO forecaster may benefit from RFC FIM.
High flows routed downstream from an RFC forecast point along the North River result in overbank flows downstream. The forecast inundation areas from the RFC FIM catch our attention. Our WFO can access a catalog of expected inundation impacts associated with the RFC forecast. If the inundation areas from the RFC FIM correspond well with the WFO's expected inundation impacts, this will give us great confidence in the forecast impacts downstream being portrayed by the RFC FIM. This helps provide decision support services directly to our partners. We will then review the National Water Model forecast and inundation information along with recent observational trends, local reports, other data sources, and local knowledge.
In this scenario, the RFC FIM can therefore serve as an important situational awareness tool to use in potential flood scenarios. The RFC FIM is only available downstream of RFC forecast points, in contrast to the NWM FIM, which may be computed using NWM flow forecasts or any NWM stream reach. The RFC FIM has the advantage of using RFC flow forecasts and therefore realizing the benefits of RFC forecaster experience and real-time adjustments.